Myself, Dr. Sanjay Nath, Assistant Professor, Manmohan Lal Metropolitan, Microbiology Department. Today, I am going to start my career with diabetes. Morphologically, it is gram negative foci. Arranged in a pair, where adjacent surfaces are flattened. It is gram negative foci. Arranged in a pair, where adjacent surfaces are flattened. It is non-motile and non-acid fast. So morphologically it is gram negative foci arranged in a pair, so it is also known as diploid foci, where adjacent surfaces are flattened. It is non-motile and non-acid fast. Culture it is aerobic in nature, it is aerobic and facultative and aerobic in nature. Optimal growth occurs at 37 degree centigrade and pH required is 7.4 to 7.6. It does not grow in ordinary medium. So, it requires blood, serum and acidic food for the development of pollen. It does not grow in ordinary medium and it requires blood, serum, acidic food for the development of the pollen. This substance does not provide, this substance does not provide nutrition to the Neisseria meningitidis, whereas it inhibits inhibitors present in sample or in media. It does not provide nutrition to the Neisseria meningitidis, whereas it inhibits inhibitors present in the medium. Some media required for the culture of Neisseria meningitidis are first blood agar media, second chocolate agar media, third higher Martin media, fourth molar Hinton media. This media required for the cultivation culture of the Neisseria meningitidis, blood agar media, chocolate agar media, higher Martin media and molar Hinton media. In these media, molar Hinton media is selective media for the culture of Neisseria meningitidis. So, culture is aerobic and facultative and aerobic. pH required 7.4 to 7.6 and temperature, optimal temperature 37 degrees centigrade. It does not grow in ordinary media, blood, serum and acidic food required for the development of pollen. And this substance does not provide nutrition, but it inhibits inhibitory substance present in the medium. Certain media required for the culture of Neisseria meningitidis are blood agar, chocolate agar, diamond media, and molar Hinton media. And among these, Mular visual media is selective media for the culture of Neisseria meningitis. Now by chemical reaction, it is catalase positive. Oxidase positive, it ferment both glucose and maltose with production of acid but no gas. It is catalase positive, oxidase positive, it ferment both glucose and maltose with production of acid but no gas. Oxidase test done by oxidase test, take oxidizing reagent, and power this oxidizing reagent on the colony present in media. After pouring of oxidizing reagent to the colony present in media, the colony becomes pink in color, and this indicates that this Neisseria meningitis is oxidase positive. Oxidizing reagent is tetramethyl paraphenylene diamine hydrochloride. So add tetramethyl paraphenylene diamine hydrochloride to the colony present in the media. And after addition of tetramethyl paraphenylene diamine hydrochloride, the colony becomes pink in color. It shows that colony is oxidase positive. Another method of oxidase test is Cobhass method. To perform Cobhass method, take a filter paper containing oxidizing reagent. Then on this filter paper, take colony of Neisseria meningitis, and then rub this colony on the filter paper with glue. And after rubbing the colony on the filter paper containing oxidizing reagent, this colony becomes pink in color, and this shows that Neisseria meningitis is oxidase positive. Here, Neisseria meningitis ferment both glucose and maltose with production of acid but no gas. It ferments both glucose and maltose with production of acid but no gas, whereas Neisseria gonorrhoeae ferment only glucose. Neisseria gonorrhoeae does not ferment maltose. So this test is differentiating test between Neisseria meningitis and Neisseria gonorrhoeae. Next, pathogenicity. Neisseria meningitis causes cerebro spinal meningitis, and secondly it causes meningococcemia. The cerebral meningitis is responsible for cerebrospinal meningitis and meningococcemia. Here, Neisseria meningitis is present in the nasopharynx without causing any symptom. Nasopharynx without causing any symptoms. There is no symptoms. Sometimes it causes pharyngitis in the patient. From the nasopharynx, it goes to central nervous system by the sheath of olfactory nerve. Perineural sheath of olfactory nerve. It crosses cerebellum plate and enters into the central nervous system. Here, in central nervous system, it causes lesions in meningeal layers. So it is present in the nasopharynx without causing any symptoms, and in some patients it causes pharyngitis. Here from the nasopharynx, so the perineural sheath of olfactory nerve, it goes to central nervous system. In central nervous system, it produces lesions in meningeal layers, especially base of brain, and spinal cord. So, cerebrospinal fluid contain large amount of Neisseria meningitis in the polymorph. Next, meningococcemia. It is severe form of meningitis. Patient develop rashes all over the body, and sometimes patient develop fulminant meningococcemia, and this fulminant meningococcemia is known as water house Petersen's syndrome, and this water house Petersen's syndrome is characterized by high fever with chill, shock, disseminated intravascular coagulation, and multi-system failure, and it has high mortality rate. So it causes meningococcemia. Meningococcemia is characterized by high fever and early stages develop rashes all over the body. These rashes contain large amounts of Neisseria meningitis. Sometimes it develops fulminant meningococcemia, and this is known as Waterhouse Petersen syndrome. It is characterized by shock, disseminated intravascular coagulation, and multi-system failure, and the fatality rate of Waterhouse Petersen syndrome and meningococcemia is very high. So these are the diseases caused by Neisseria meningitis. Next, diagnosis. Diagnosis of Neisseria meningitis is very important, because meningitis is also caused by so many organisms. Sample is taken as symptom traveler, sample is taken as cerebrospinal fluid, blood, nasopharyngeal swab, rashes. So these are the site from where we can take sample for the diagnosis of Neisseria meningitis. Take cerebrospinal fluid from the meningitis patient and divide cerebrospinal fluid in three test tubes. Test tube A, B and C. Take several samples from the meningitis patient, suffering from severe meningitis, and take and divide the several samples into three test tubes A, B, C. The A test tube is centrifuged, and from the deposit, make a smear and do gram staining. After gram staining, observe under microscope, and if you find diplococci where adjacent surfaces are flattened, then start treatment immediately. From the supernatant layers of cerebrospinal fluid, we can detect antigen. We can detect antigen of Neisseria meningitis. So, first test tube is centrifuged, and from the deposit, we can make a smear and do gram staining. After gram staining, observe under microscope, and you will find gram negative diplococci where adjacent surfaces are flattened. From the supernatant layer of the cerebrospinal fluid, we can detect antigen. From the B test tube, cerebrospinal fluid is inoculated in media like blood agar media, chocolate agar media, thyroid marty media, and Müller Hinkel media. From the B, cerebrospinal fluid is inoculated in blood agar media, chocolate agar media, thyroid marty media, and Müller Hinkel media. Inoculate overnight at 37 degrees centigrade. After end of overnight inoculation, we will find a small translucent glistening colony which are easily emulsified, and then do biochemical reactions with the colony. It will be catalase positive, it will be oxidase positive, and it will ferment both glucose and maltose with production of acid and gas. From the C, equal volume of bile broth is added to the cerebrospinal fluid. And after addition of bile broth to the equal volume of cerebrospinal fluid, inoculate in solid media and incubate at 37 degrees centigrade for 24 hours overnight. And you will find a small colony, translucent colony, is the irreversible colony, and two biochemical reactions with the colony. It will again show oxidase positive, catalase positive, and ferment glucose and maltose with production of acid and gas. Next diagnosis, method of diagnosis. Blood culture. For blood culture, take 5 ml of blood and add 50 ml of bile broth. 50 ml of bile broth. Then inoculate at 37 degrees centigrade overnight, and inoculate blood in 50 ml of bile broth, and then incubate at 37 degrees centigrade for 24 hours, and then again incubate in solid media like blood agar media, chocolate agar media, thyroid marty media, and Müller Hinkel media. Next diagnosis, examination of nasopharyngeal swab. Take sample from the nasopharynx and do microscopical and culture from the swab. After microscopical examination, we will find gram negative 2.45 where adjacent surfaces are flattened and are for culture inoculate in solid medium. Incubate at 37 degrees centigrade for 24 hours and after 24 hours do biochemical reactions and it will confirm the diagnosis. Nasal frequent swab examination is done mostly in carrier patients. Next, examination of rashes. These rashes contain large amount of Neisseria meningitidis. Take sample from the rashes, make a smear and do gram staining. And after gram staining, observe under microscope and you will find gram negative cryptococci where adjacent surfaces are flattened. Again, we can do culture from the sample taken from the rashes. Next, diagnosis is done by autopsy. If there is death of a patient suffering from Neisseria meningitidis, take sample within 12 hours. Because after 12 hours, this Neisseria meningitidis does not survive in the dead body. And sample is taken especially from the base of the brain and ventricles. And again do microscopical examination and culture of the sample. So autopsy sample is taken within 12 hours because after 12 hours the Neisseria meningitis does not survive and especially sample is taken from the base of the brain and ventricles. And do microscopical examination and culture from the sample. Clear of this? Sanjay ji. So, do I list Neisseria meningitis?